When I discuss management of atrial fibrillation with patients, I really try to educate them that there are two independent issues we need to address. The first, and arguably the most important, is the inherent thromboembolic or stroke risk associated with the condition. Roughly 20 to 25% of all strokes in America are likely caused by atrial fibrillation, and as such, that needs to be the first order of business, making a decision about what, if anything, needs to be done to prevent that. Some patients, it's simply nothing. Other patients, it's aspirin. Other patients, it's stronger blood thinners, such as warfarin or the newer agents, dabigatran, rivaroxaban. Once we've dealt with the stroke risk associated with the atrial fibrillation for an individual patient, the next decision tree is how to manage the symptoms. Basically, there are two very different but good ways to approach the symptoms. One is to simply use relatively simple medications to control the heart rate in atrial fibrillation. These are not thought to necessarily keep one in or out of rhythm, but rather they help patients when they go into AFib not feel so symptomatic. Those would be called AV nodal agents. The second type of medication, which is often used for symptomatic patients, is what we call rhythm control medications. There's approximately six medications approved. That's primary job is to keep patients in rhythm. Now, these medications are slightly stronger medications than the rate control rhythms, but ultimately, usually a very reasonable medication regimen can be found for a patient to keep them in normal rhythm or, at a minimum, control their symptoms when they go into the arrhythmia. The challenge with medications is that they effectively put a governor on even normal heart rhythm. And so the single biggest complaint or concern with the medicines is not that they don't control the arrhythmia, but rather they limit one's functioning when they're in normal rhythm. And that would manifest classically as someone who's a conditioned athlete just notices they can't perhaps work out as much or to the same extent on the medications. It's hard to put a number on it, but roughly if your peak heart rate's 140 beats a minute, if we put you on some of these agents, you might notice it's only 125 or 130. So it's not per se a side effect of the medicine. It's an expected outcome, although a lot of patients really don't like that, especially if they're very active patients.